I hear blue jays in the background. I hear jets flying overhead. It is Friday morning. I even hear my phone. I love being outside, and I just love to see birds, nature, and deer, and those kind of things. That's why we go out in Jeeps frequently, so we can get out and see that. But I don't love mosquitoes, and the mosquitoes have been a little bit crazy here recently. With all the rain that we have, I guess I need to check the backyard and make sure that there's not anywhere where the larvae are growing. That would be helpful.
Good morning.
In your Christianity, sometimes we have areas in our heart where we have allowed mosquito larvae to breed, and they just want to come and grow up, turn into mosquitoes, and bite you in a spiritual sense. So if there's areas in your life that you know are harboring potential future problems, it's best to deal with them early on.
Definitely.
Early on in your Christianity, early on in your day, early on in your marriage, early on in your job.
I have big marks on my glasses.
And she's going to deal with that. But good morning, I'm Matt.
And I'm Randy.
And you've just tuned into the Morning Devotion. We're here to encourage you through the Word so that you can be strong in the faith.
And live victoriously in Christ.
Amen. Let's pray. Go ahead.
Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this morning. Father, we thank you for your Word. We thank you for the so many blessings that you bestow upon us, Lord, that we take for granted. God Almighty, just a lot of the little tiny things, Lord. Father, we praise you and we thank you as we get into your Word. Holy Spirit, teach us, guide us, direct our thoughts, direct our hearts toward God. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Good morning, Lisa.
Good morning. Glad
to have you online with us this morning. It is the book of John, the Gospel according to John, and we are in the 8th chapter. You ever notice that vine behind us? Did you notice that last season, last fall, that this whole fence was covered with a vine?
As you look at the old videos.
Well, it went all the way down. It was a beautiful backdrop. Well, over here is a big tree. And the vine had somehow gotten around the front of the tree. And we didn't want it going up the tree. We just wanted it going down the fence. So we cut three lines on the vine that went around the front of the tree. And within a matter of days, 70% of that back fence vine started turning brown and wilting. What we did not know is the majority of that portion of the vine, which runs all down the fence, was those three lines that came around the tree. Yeah. Jesus said something in our text today that is similar to that. Those vines weren't going to survive when we separated them from the main feed of the vine. And Jesus referred to himself as the vine and said, if you abide in me and I abide in you, then you'll be able to ask what you want and be able to be alive. But if not, you're going to be like a vine that's cut off and wither away and die. Spiritually first, that's the first part, is that you spiritually begin to die off. Everyone dies pretty much in the end. We all know that that's eventually coming.
Judgment day
but
comes.
But the spiritual death happens gradually over time. Sometimes it starts with missing church, not giving in offerings. Maybe your friends change. Maybe your language changes. Maybe things irritate you a little bit more. Maybe you become a little less giving. Maybe you start drinking. Maybe you start doing drugs again. Maybe you become unfaithful to your spouse. That's spiritual decline. And it does sadden me to see when friends that we have or people that we've known have slid into that state. We're praying for you. And we're asking God, renew you and revive you and put that fervor and that dedication that was in you before, where God was the most important thing in your life. Abiding in Jesus was the most important thing ever. That you could not get enough scripture, prayer, church time, fellowship. Those are signs of someone who's abiding in the vine. Go ahead and read that text.
John 8:31 says, "Then Jesus said to those Jews which believed on him." So these were people that had believed on him. But there's something he says about believing on him. It says,
it's right here, highlighted in green.
"If ye continue in my word, then are ye my disciples indeed. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free." See, it's easy to believe, but if you really believe, then you're going to continue to search. You're going to continue to want to abide and be in that fellowship. I have something here that says, "Followers of Jesus' disciples continue in God's word. The truth we learn from continuing the word brings freedom into our lives. It is freedom from sin, sickness, Satan, and the curse. The word continue is the Greek word meno, that is translated as abide. In Jesus' teaching on the vine and the branches, in John 15, 14, 6, 7, and 10, and it means to continue, to remain, abide, to stay in a given place, state, relation, and expectancy. John 15, 4 says this. I'm going to read a few verses here. It says, abide in me and I in you. Do you want to read that?
No, go ahead.
Okay. As a branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine. You are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. If anyone does not abide in me, he is cast out as a branch and is withered, and they gather them and throw them into the fire."
You know what we did with these old branches that died? We threw them out.
Yep, and they burned. "If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire and it shall be done for you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit. So you will be my disciples. As the Father loved me, I also have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandment and abide in his love."
And how did Jesus love? In chapter 13, verse 34, it says, "A new commandment I give unto you." This is Jesus talking. "A new commandment I give unto you, that you love one another, as I have loved you, and ye also should love one another. By this shall all men know that you are my disciples, if you have love one for another." Jesus didn't give it as an option that we should love one another. Jesus said, "A new commandment I give unto you, that we should show love." How is that possible? Well, it's possible because when you are connected to the vine, when you're connected to Jesus, and God's word is in your heart, then the life-giving force that would flow like through a vine to give life to the ends and to all of the growth is when you're abiding in Jesus, then that same life and love and compassion and mercy and wisdom and even the power of the Holy Ghost flows through your connection to Jesus, and it allows you to love people the way he loved people.
Amen.
Jesus loves you so much he gave his life for you. He gave his life to whether you've never accepted him or whether you are going to church every single week. Jesus gave his life for you, that you might have life. And not just life,
but abundant life.
And when you have abundant life, it's not so hard to keep a praise song in your heart and rejoice in the Lord always.
Amen.
And again,
I say,
rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord today. It's Friday. Make plans for church this Sunday. Whatever church you're going to, or whatever church you haven't been into in a while, make plans this Sunday to attend church. You'll be glad you did. God bless. We love you. We'll see you tomorrow morning. 7 o'clock. We don't know where.
Yep.
But we'll see you tomorrow morning at 7 o'clock. God bless.